The outer diameter of a Francis runner is 1.4 meter. The flow velocity at inlet is 9.5 meter per second. The absolute velocity at the exit is 7 meter per second. The speed of operation is 430 rpm. The power developed is 12.25 megawatt with a flow rate of 12 meter cube per second. Total head is 115 meter. For shockless entry, determine the angle of the inlet guide vane. Also find the absolute velocity at entrance, the runner blade angle at inlet, and the loss of head in the unit. Assume zero whirl at exit. Also find the specific speed. So first write down the given. Before that, I am drawing here first a velocity triangle, inlet and outlet velocity triangle. So this is one of the vane of Francis turbine. So for Francis turbine, this is the inlet velocity triangle, in which this is absolute velocity at inlet, this is relative velocity at inlet, this is velocity of flow at inlet, now this is velocity of whirl at inlet, VW1, this is U1, that is velocity, peripheral velocity of vane at inlet. Now we have given that, assume zero whirl at exit. That means velocity in velocity triangle, there is no whirl velocity. So outlet velocity triangle is like this. So there is no whirl velocity. So Vf2, that is velocity of flow at outlet, is nothing but velocity, absolute velocity at outlet. And this is U2, which is velocity, peripheral velocity at outlet, and this is relative velocity at outlet. Now this is guide vane angle at inlet, that is alpha. This is vane angle at inlet. Now this is vane angle at outlet, and this is guide vane angle at outlet. So here beta is 90 degree. For assume zero whirl at exit, so for that beta is equal to 90 degree. So this is the inlet and outlet velocity triangle for Francis turbine. Now what is given? The outer diameter of Francis turbine. So outer diameter means diameter at inlet. This is inner side of runner, this is outer side of runner. So outer diameter means diameter at inlet. So D1 is given as 1.4 meter. The flow velocity at inlet, that is Vf1. So Vf1 is given 9.5 meter per second. The absolute velocity at the exit, that is V2, that is Vf2. So V2 is given as 7 meter per second. The speed of operation is, speed n is equal to 430 rpm. Speed of runner is 430 rpm. The power developed, that is shaft power, so 12.25 megawatt, that is equal to 12.25 into 10 raised to 6 watt. That is 12.25 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatt also. So with a flow rate means Q is given, that is 12 meter cube per second. Total head, so H, capital H is given, 115 meter. For shockless entry, determine the angle of the inlet guide vane. So guide angle at inlet, guide vane angle at inlet. So we have to find, first is guide vane angle at inlet. So this alpha is a guide vane angle at inlet. Now second, also find the absolute velocity at entrance. So this is entrance, this is exit. So absolute velocity at entrance is V1. V1. Now third, the runner blade angle at inlet. So theta is a runner blade angle at inlet. And the loss of head in the unit. 4 is H loss. So loss of head in the unit. Assume zero whirl at exit. That is VW2 is equal to 0. Also find the specific speed. So fifth is ms, specific speed. Now let us see which formula we require. So formula, so let us see one by one. So first is alpha. So for alpha, you can see from this triangle tan alpha is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1. So tan alpha is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1. So Vf1, we know the value of Vf1. We don't know the value of Vw1. So first point, we have to find first Vw1. So Vw1, how we can find Vw1? So we know the formula of power. So power is equal to P is equal to rho Q Vw1 U1. So rho Q Vw1 U1. From this, power is given. Rho we know for water is 1000 kg per meter cube. Q is given. Vw1 we have to find. Now what is the value of U1? So U1 we can find out from pi D1n divided by 60. Now D1 is given, n is given, so we can easily find out U1 and then Vw1 and then alpha. Now second one is V1. So how we can find out V1? So let us see in the inlet velocity triangle. So this is V1 and we have to find this V1. Now we know Vf1, Vw1. So this is the right angle triangle. Now by using Pythagoras theorem, we can find out easily V1. So V1 square, V1 is a hypotenuse. So V1 square is equal to Vf1 square plus Vw1 square. So from this we can find out V1. Now third one is theta. So how to find theta? Let us see in the diagram. This is theta. So this is one triangle, right angle triangle. So from this, tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by, what is the value of this line? So this side is total is Vw1 minus this U1. So Vw1 minus U1. So tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1 minus U1. Now we know Vf1, Vw1, U1. We can easily find out theta. Now fourth is H loss. So head loss in the unit. Now at the inlet of turbine, this is the inlet of turbine, this is exit of runner, this is inlet of runner, this is one of the vane of runner. Now at the entry of turbine or entry of runner, the head available is this head, 115 meter. Now from this head we have to minus the head used for developing power or head used for work done. So runner develop power or runner develop power, so for that head is required. So some head is lost for the or used for work done. Now minus some head is available at outlet because there is velocity V2. So some head, kinetic head is available at outlet. So that kinetic head is V2 square divided by 2G. So head in V2. This is head in, so head in दिस इज अवेलेबल हेड माइनस हेड यूज्ड फॉर वर्क डन, एम आई राइटिंग हियर, हेड यूज्ड फॉर वर्क डन माइनस हेड यूज्ड फॉर दिस वी टू और हेड इन वी टू. नाउ द रिमेनिंग हेड फ्रॉम दिस, द रिमेनिंग हेड इज नथिंग बट हेड लॉस बिकॉज हेड अवेलेबल एट इनलेट इज एच, सम ऑफ द हेड इज यूज्ड फॉर वर्क डन, सम ऑफ द हेड इज अवेलेबल एट आउटलेट एंड द रिमेनिंग हेड फ्रॉम द टोटल हेड दैट इज नथिंग बट हेड लॉस. इट मे बी ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन और समथिंग, सो दैट हेड लॉस वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. नाउ फिफ्थ इज एनएस, सो स्पेसिफिक स्पीड. तो फॉर्मूला फॉर स्पेसिफिक स्पीड फॉर टर्बाइन इज एन रूट पी डिवाइडेड बाय एच रेस टू 5/4. एन इज आरपीएम, स्पीड ऑफ द टर्बाइन इन आरपीएम. पी इज अ शाफ्ट पावर इन किलोवॅट एंड एच इज अ टोटल हेड इन मीटर. सो वी हैव टू यूज दिस फॉर्म्युलेज एंड सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लेम. वन्स यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस, वन्स यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस मच पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लेम, देन रिमेनिंग पार्ट इज नॉट दैट मच डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज यू हैव टू ओनली पुट द वैल्यूज इन दिस फॉर्मुलेज एंड गेट द आंसर्स. सो लेट अस सी द सोल्यूशन. सो वन बाय वन वी सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लेम. सो आई एम स्टार्टिंग हियर सोल्यूशन. Let us see how to solve this problem. So first find out u1, so pi d1 n divided by 60, that is equal to pi into d1 is 1.4 into n, 430 is given, divided by 60. So u, the value of u becomes, 31.52. 31.52 meter per second. Now this is the value of u1. Now find out from this formula, find out vw1. So power is equal to, you know, rho q vw1 into u1. So power is given, 12.25 into 10 raised to 6 is equal to rho is 1000 into q 10 into VW1 we have to find, into U1 is 31.52. So now this all the values, will go to denominator, and VW1 is equal to, so put that values in calculator and you can get 12.25 into 10 raised to 6 divided by, these values goes to denominator, so 1000 into 10 into 31.52, so you can get the value of velocity of whirlwind inlet, that is VW1, is equal to 32.3861 meter per second. Now we can find out, we can find the value of alpha. Now tan alpha is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1, that is equal to Vf1 is given 9.5 divided by Vw1, 32.3861. So tan alpha is equal to 0.2933. Now alpha is equal to what? Tan inverse this answer to 0.2933. So alpha becomes 16.34 degree. So this is the value of alpha. So this is the answer of this first question. Now second is V1. So use Pythagoras theorem for this triangle. You have to use Pythagoras theorem. So V1 square is equal to Vf1 square plus Vw1 square. So V1 square is equal to Vf1, the value of Vf1 is 9.5 square, plus The value of VW1 is 32.3861 square. So now V1 square becomes, V1 square is equal to 1139.1094. So V1, take a root of this value and you can get 33.75 meter per second. This is the value of absolute velocity at entrance. Now third one is vane angle at inlet. Vane angle at inlet. So for that we will use this formula for this triangle. So tan theta is equal to Vf1 divided by Vw1 minus U1. Now we know all the values, so simply put the values. So Vf1 is 9.5 divided by Vw1 is 32.3861 minus U1 is 31.52. So you can get tan theta is equal to, put all the values in calculator and you can get this tan theta is equal to 10.9687. So theta is equal to nothing but tan inverse this value, 10.9687. So theta becomes 84.79 degree. Now fourth is head loss, H loss. We write formula for H loss as H minus H used for work done, minus H in V2, or H at head available at outlet. Now what is this H used for work done? Head used for work done. Now we know the formula of power. I am writing here the formula of power. That is T is equal to P is equal to, we know, rho Q Vw1 into U1. Now this power is in watt. Watt is nothing but Newton meter per second. Watt is nothing but Newton meter per second. Now we require head. So we require only this meter. So we have to eliminate this Newton per second. So I am dividing this power by weight. So power per unit weight is nothing but head. So weight W dot. So weight per second, weight of water per second. So rho Q Vw1 U1 divided by this W dot is nothing but M dot into G. So weight flow rate is nothing but mass flow rate into G. Now M dot is nothing but rho Q. So this will be cancelled and head is nothing but Vw1 U1 divided by G. So use this formula for over here. So H loss, head loss is equal to total head available H is 115 minus this formula Vw1 U1 divided by G minus, now head available at outlet is nothing but V2 square divided by 2G. Now put all the values. So 115 minus Vw1, we know that is Vw1 32.3861 into U1 is 31.52 divided by G 9.81 minus V2. The value of V2 is, I write down here. So given V2 is equal to 7 meter per second. So 7 square divided by 2 into 9.81. Now put the values in calculator. So 115 minus this value becomes 104.058 minus this value becomes 2.4974. So again put the values in calculator, you can get head loss is equal to 8.444 meter. So this much head is lost in the total unit. Now fifth is specific speed. So specific speed ns is equal to n root p divided by h raised to 5/4. So put n in rpm, so n is given in rpm 430 into put the power in kilowatt 12.25 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatt divided by h total head available 115 raised to 5/4. Now put this all the values in calculator, you can get the specific speed as 126.3758. So this is the specific speed. So in this way you can calculate all the values which we have to ask in this question. So this is the problem on Francis turbine.